All right, guys. Well, we're back with an update here before we go into episode two. So I grabbed Allie again. I've been running back and forth a little bit during the build. So this is kind of where I'm at right now. And then you're actually going to see like the steps leading up to this after we do this intro. So Allie, I kind of wanted to bring you in and kind of chat with you about some of the things that I noticed or needed a little help with. Sure. And I think the first thing is going to be just the hinges. As far as actually like drilling the hole and getting the glue to actually wick in there. So I don't know if you want to elaborate a little bit on why that's important.
Yeah, I'd love to. You're obviously following the manual, and the first step is the hinges. The Sino-type hinges, there are different types. There are Sino, there are ones that use epoxy, there are pin hinges. Sino hinges have worked really well for us out of the hundreds and hundreds of models that I've built prior to joining Horizon, and then the hundreds and hundreds since joining Horizon. I've never had an issue with the Sino hinge. I do hear otherwise. I do hear some people say, oh, they don't like them. I do believe that a lot of it is due to not understanding the process or the application. Mm-hmm. The main thing is, in the manual, we call out drilling a single pinhole in the middle of the hinge. You'll see it covered.
Yep.
It seems like a step, but a lot of people, and I did before I joined here, I was using different hinges. I just bypassed it. And the first set of hinges I glued in, when I came to give them the tug test to make sure they're fully secure, came out every time. What's happening is, because the slot is only very thinly cut in the trailing edge of the wing, the glue isn't seeping in fully and grabbing it. It works on, it's a plastic hinge covered in a furry type material. The thin glue drips in, grabs that furry material which expands and grabs the wood around it. The hole is really, really important to that because it allows a channel for the glue to seep in. Otherwise, what can happen is it can sit on the surface, and the surface is a shiny film which the glue doesn't stick to. So, I watched you do it, which was perfect. You followed the steps, mark the center, drill a hole, hold the hinge, hold the surface upright if you can.
Yeah.
That's just a simple, cheap thing so the glue
runs gravity.
In. and doesn't run on the floor, or as my case used to be all over my jeans.
Yeah.
Hold the surface upright if you can, and less is more. You really don't need to apply a lot of glue into that hinge line because you're using the capillary action, goes down and expands, and the correct glue.
Okay.
Sino, right? No, there are so many different types. There's thin, there's thick, there's slow, there's gel. For Sino hinges, it has to be a thin type, almost like water. And remember that when you're applying it.
Yeah, it's very runny.
You don't want a big nozzle and just pour it in there because it will end up ruining your wing.
Yeah.
So just hold it vertical, a nice applicator, fresh bottle of thin CA, and just drip it in either side.
Now the other thing, right after that, I immediately realized I had all four, I should say both ailerons, both flaps out, and I'm like, wait, is there a difference between the left and the right? There is. And Allie actually showed where the control horn goes in.
Correct.
It's a good way to where if you didn't label them ahead of time, you can work it back out. But Allie recommended just put a little piece of tape on the edge of the wing and just label left, left, right, right. That way you kind of avoid a potential mistake. There's ways around it, but...
You can put tape, a little pen mark. Yeah. Same with the stab as well, don't forget, because you asked me the same question with the stab. Yeah. They will fit you the side, but then you'll have the control horn putting out the top of the wing, which is a bad day. just mark them up.
Yeah. The other thing, while we're still talking about the hinges, this is my first ARF, like we said before. What kind of acceptable gaps I should see between the wing surface and the actual, like mostly the aileron, because the flap, it's covered up top. And I think Allie said it was just fine, but I don't know if there's kind of a, you don't want it too tight, too loose, or just kind of let it settle how it sits.
On the X Cub, the wing sort of denotes that, because you have a trailing edge here at the foot of the wing. X Cub on the
same thing.
You have the trailing edge of the wing here. So obviously if you put the flap extended of that or inboard of that, it will look, obviously wrong. And the same, follow that line there and the wingtip there.
Yep.
Generally leads to a small gap between the control surface and the wing.
Which I think I show, hopefully.
Yeah, I remember you doing it. You were worried about that. It's not that critical. You can have it almost butt joined and the hinge will do the work.
Right.
What you don't want to have is a massive gap. And that's just an aerodynamic thing and more so an aesthetic thing. You don't want it to look, all misaligned. But you've got it nailed, it's perfect.
We went over the glue. I think the only other thing I had was actually not really covered in the manual, but getting your servo horn centered on your servos. That way you don't have to bind everything up and then realize all your flaps and ailerons start going different directions because you didn't have your stuff centered. So Allie had a tool that we actually used, and we have something new from Spectrum, correct, that will do this as well.
It's awesome. Like I said, Carl says in the manual, it just says send to your servo.
Right.
This thing. This is more than just a servo center. This is a new Spectrum smart battery checker, yep, which has a servo test and servo centering device built in. These are invaluable when you're building,
yep,
just simply because you don't want to have to get your transmitter out, a receiver, yep, a receiver battery. It's nice just to go from one servo to the other, yep, to the other, to the other. Keep it handy, super useful, get it centered, and that way you don't have any hidden surprises. What sometimes happens is you plonk the servo horn on, you screw it up without centering, you measure up all your linkages, and you switch on, and bang, you know, it goes up to one, and you're like, oh, I have to take it all apart. Temptation is to sub-trim that out. It's really best to just take a little bit of caution at the early stage, and you don't have to do any sub-trim.
Perfect. Well, we're going to jump into, like I said, some more of that time-lapse stuff, and I'm also going to hop in and out, so you'll probably see when I got to one of these issues, you'll see me probably stop and kind of chat about it real quick. So just stay tuned. It's not all time lapse, so you shouldn't get too bored. But yeah, we're already, it looks like a plane now, so that's good. But just started working with the horizontal slab actually isn't attached yet. I just have it, I don't know if you can actually see that wiggling. So that's where I'm at right now in the manual. So you'll probably, in this video, get to that point. And then we'll go to the next episode. Al, is there anything else that I forgot to mention that you can think of?
Yeah, just looking at it now, some of you may be able to pick up on the screen covering.
That's right.
A lot of wrinkles in the covering. This is perfectly normal. We get asked this question a lot. People think it's maybe a prerequisite of a poor covering job done by the factory. Mm. I know it's easy for me to say standing here, but it isn't. It's a humidity thing. So the wood is naturally has humidity affect it, so it has moisture within it. Mm-hmm. Goes from a very hot environment to Illinois, which right now at minus something in the 30s in the wind chill. Even in this temperature, right, in the room, it's a different humidity to when the plane was built. So to see these wrinkles is perfectly acceptable. Mm-hmm. It's normal. I'd be questioning if there wasn't any wrinkles almost. Don't worry about it at this stage. We will tackle it later on.
Yep.
There is devices, heat sealing iron, heat sealing gun, that we recommend in the manual, that you can get these wrinkles out. So personally, I know a lot of people would chase those wrinkles out and it's a nuisance aesthetically, but don't worry, leave it till the end and we can do it all in one go. We'll probably actually do it before we put the windows in.
Okay.
Sounds daft, the only reason is because we're going at, obviously, the surface with quite high heat, we don't want to affect the windows.
Makes sense.
But at that stage, we'll talk through how we can get all these wrinkles out.
Yeah, I personally, the wings didn't look too bad. Once I actually was kind of putting them onto the fuselage, I'm like, man, this is all loose. I'm like, should I iron it? And he's like, no, don't do it yet.
So. It's the nature of the product. You know, it's a heat shrink covering. So yeah, don't sweat it.
Perfect. Well, hopefully you guys enjoy this. Again, keep us updated with questions. We're going to try to answer everything, but if there's anything like super specific, give us some time. We might not be able to tackle everything right away. And then if you're watching this years from now, sorry, we'll try to monitor it. But obviously, you know, bear in mind that there's YouTube as a good resource. There's RC groups.
Yeah, the RC groups forum, for those unaware, has I think it's probably up to 400 page build thread specifically on this airplane, where a lot of individuals, I mean, I'm on there at the early stages, but a lot of individuals over the last 3 years have taken them, built them, had really cool ideas like how to make the lights work. There's the simpleton's way, which is my way, of just plugging it in. But some guys have built modules that make the lights flash and stuff like that. But they're all tackled on forums. And YouTube, like Carl said, we had one question come in about, will this engine fit? Took me 10 seconds in YouTube to find a link, send it to the customer, the engine fits. Yep. So yeah, feel free to use those and we will try and help as much as we can.
Yeah, perfect. Well, we'll see you guys next episode. Well, you'll see me a couple more times here, but thanks again to Allie.
Pleasure.
We're still going good. So we're going to keep it up and try to get this knocked out before we can even have the privilege to fly it, because it's bad outside right now.
Yeah.
All right, see you guys later. Hey guys, quick update here for you. So, essentially got the wings completely assembled at this point. Servos are installed. One little tip I'd recommend is when you do pull your lead through for your aileron and your flap servo, reuse some of the tape that was, actually, there's a good example of why. Reuse some of the tape that you had from the existing string. That way you can handle your wing without losing your end and having to fish it back out.